Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Maria Sheila Hani Lacuna Pangan, Mayor, City of Manila. A round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. She is being welcomed by the District Director of Manila Police District, Police Brigadier General, Andre Perez Rizon. Good morning, ma'am, and welcome to Manila Police District.
Thank you. Deputy Regional Director natin.
And that concludes the guest book writing of our guest of honor and speaker. Thank you, ma'am, and thank you, ma'am, and once again, good morning. Welcome to Manila Police District, your Manila's finest.
Please remain standing for the invocation to be led by Police Colonel Marlo L. Lavares, Chief RCHS NCRPO.
Lead us with ourselves to the Holy Spirit in Sunday. Let us pray. Our loving God, we invoke your blessings on this third of our ceremony. Those who are participants and those who are gathered here to witness the turnover and assumption of office. As Police Brigadier General Andrew Dizon comes to the end of his tenure as District Director of Manila Police District, we look back and are thankful for his concern and care for his personnel, for example as a leader, and for his loyalty to his superiors, his peers, and his subordinates. Lord, it has been a privilege working with him. Thank you for allowing him to come to you, to our way. We ask you to grant our incoming acting District Director of MPD, Police Colonel Ronald Thomas Levi, the gifts of wisdom, courage, and strength. May his time of command in the MPD be one blessing for him, for all the police officers, non-uniform personnel, and the people. We always strive to assist every police officer to grow and develop so that each can be an effective and efficient law enforcer to the community. Finally, bless perpetually Police Brigadier General Jose Melen Jose Matamis Jr., our Acting Regional Director of NCRPO, the presiding officer, and Honorable Maria Sheila Lacuna Pangan, Mayor, City of Manila, our Guest of Honor and Speaker. May your grace abound in us, O Lord, to all of us participants in today's momentous ceremony. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Thank you, and please be seated. And now, ladies and gentlemen, let us hear the welcome remarks from the Deputy District Director of Administration of Manila Police District. Please all welcome Police Colonel Upuan, sir.
To our guest of honor, Speaker, Honorable Chief Asmira Tulatana, the Mayor of City of Manila, of course, our presiding officer, Police Brigadier General Jose Melecho Sina Tapis Newport, to our outgoing City Director, Police Brigadier General Ate Perez Pizoder, to our retiring City Director of the Manila Police District, Police Colonel Arnold Tumas, City Vicer. Of course, we call our former City Director of the Manila Police District, Police Brigadier General Roberto Delano, sir. Sa ating award, Police General Roberto A. Pastor. Sa ating Chief, Sir Father Marlo Lavares. Members of the community data sa 96. Lastly, our Director. The regional staff, this staff, of course, our VP, Adiyake, Police Brigadier General Leyte, Abunugan. The family of our Director, Madam Ma'am, Mahika, so the Director.
And the significant of this event that are forthcoming. Again,
visit the home of Manila's finest. Magandang araw sa inyo.
Thank you very much for that warm welcome, sir. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we will proceed with the presentation of awards and mental health going this year and record of Manila Police District. With this, we are requesting this morning speaker, Marco Maria Shimahanida Pumapakan, together with the Acquisition of the Director of the NCRPO, Police Brigadier General Officer and National Academy's Chairman, for the presentation of awards and mental. Salutation reads, in pursuit of the General Order Number HQ4804, dated October 17, 2023, for his exceptional performance of major responsibility as the District Director of Manila Police District National Capital Region Police Office from August 8, 2022 to October 16, 2023. His high sense of responsibility and dedication to duty resulted in the delivery of quality police service to the community, which earned credit not only for itself, but also for the whole national police. The Manila is awarded to Police Brigadier General Humphrey Ferris Pizan, offering as well as in Captain by the order of the Chairman of the National Police Commission, Official Police General by the Order General Chief PNP, signed by Police Major General Robert P. Williams, and the
Thank you very much. And now, to deliver this message and for the reading of relinquishment of office, may we now request the outgoing District Director of Manila Police District, Police Brigadier General Andres Perez Dizon. Sir.
Kanina mo ba kapag-isip ko, una ko nabasa ko na mensahe na kanina. Galing sa isang kaibigan, at galing sa isang galing district director ng Manila Police District, at hindi ko naman dito pa. Parehas yung mensahe nila. Yung one chronicles sa 1611, sasabi, look to the Lord and His strength, and seek His face for this. So, ang ibig sabihin lang po para sa akin, na ang tayong Panginoon lang po ang ating pag-asa at sabihin. Para magandang umagaw po sa akin. Ang mensahe ko po ito ay puno lang po ng pasasalamat. And of course, unahin ko po na sasabihin sa bawat isa na ang Manila Police District ay nasa mabuting kamay sa ilalim ng pamumuno ng ating bagong district director na si Skeller na Tom Tibay. Napakan natin po. Si Kanyang Tibay po ay katulad din namin ng ating regional director at ating former director na si General Roy Miranda na nanggaling sa Philippine Special Action Force. So, unang nagkita kami ni Kanyang Tibay doon sa Bataan during the epic noong 1996. Kinalugan namin yung kagubatan ng Bataan at sinecure natin yung mga international leaders na nag-participate sa inyo. So, the rest is history. Ngayon, kasama ko dito. Unang-una po, nagpapasalamat ako sa Panginoon na nandito pa rin ako tayo sa harap mo at siguro may purpose pa na nakita tayo. Ang dakilang arkitekto ng San Buta. Sa ating Pangulo, sa ating Sekretary ng DNLD, sa ating Porter CPNP, sa ating President ng CPNP, sa ating former Regional Director, sa ating Regional Director ngayon na si General Jose Melenzo C. Narcantes Jr., and of course, sa ating inamahal na punong lungsod ng Maynila na si Ma'am Hani Lacuna. Si Ma'am Hani, nung una, reluctant siya sa akin na kanilaki ng buo. Eventually, isang mga people na chance to serve at the Lord. Ngayon, tinanong niya kayo. Mahirap pa po ako. Para sa kalaman ng ating mga bisita, lalo na ating regional director, ating DRDA, mga pamilya ni Kalatigan, at ang bahay, ang ating unang lungsod po ay buhos ang suporta sa ating Manila Police District. Yung sinasabi ng ating regional director na human, logistical, at financial support, lahat po yun pinagkakaloob ng ating mayora sa pamamagitan. Pag human, lahat po ng sangay ng kanyang departamento sa isang hingi lang po ng tulong, lahat po nagpapag-district. So hindi po nahirapan na sir yung Manila Police District dahil suportado po tayo ng total government. At doon naman po sa logistical sir, gasolina, sasakyan, communication equipment, lahat po pinagkakalos sa atin ang aming sito. At sa financial support po, mga special activities, pinag-provide ng ating mayora, yung pagkain, pagbibigyan kami ng pagkain, pati na po, kung sasunin ang ating mga patrona. ating anim congressman ng Maynila na nagpakita, patuloy na lang papakita ng mga malasakit sa ating mga polis. Ubus din ang kanilang suporta. Of course, instruction din ang ating mga kapatid. Pati na po ang ating mga councilor sa ating distrito, lahat po sila, wala po, bilang lang po sa daliri kung may hindi nagpapakabot ng suporta sa ating mga polis. At nagpapasalamat din po ako sa mga partner na agencies, ibang ahensya ng gobyerno, sa mga private organizations, pati na po sa ating Manila Police District Rest Corps, na mula nung tiniente ako dito, hanggang ngayon, wag na kaibigan pa rin, hindi na siya kaya, hindi mingyente. And lastly, to the men and women of Manila Police District, maraming salamat, and let us always go to our name, we are Manila's finest. Wala po sa inyong dating district director, maraming salamat. National Headquarters, Philippine National Police, Camp Brigadier General Bakay Tikram in Quezon City, relinquishment of office. Pursuant to paragraph 2, General Orders Number NSQ-GO-TDS-2023-4690, National Headquarters, Philippine National Police, dated October 16, 2023, I hereby relinquish my position as District Director, Manila Police District, National Capital Region Police Office, Philippine National Police, effective October 17, 2023, and I wholeheartedly, willingly, and gladly sign in your presence.
Thank you. Assumption of office. Pursuant to paragraph 3, General Orders Number NHQ-GO-DS-2023-4691, National Headquarters, National Police, dated October 16, 2023, I hereby assume the position as Acting District Director, Manila Police District, National Capital, Region Police Office, Philippine National Police, effective October 17, 2023. And I sign.
Thank you.
to take on this role as acting district director of the Manila Police District. And of course, to the PNP Seniors Officers Placement and Promotion Board, led by Police Lieutenant General Rodrigo Sermonia, our Deputy Chief PNP for Administration, for the approval of the resolution that has permitted the PNP Class 1996 to undertake more significant opportunities and responsibilities. And of course, my classmates, my members of Class 96, thank you for your friendship and your steadfast support in the years. My mentors, my senior officers, my upperclassmen, who championed for me and vouched for my abilities whose unwavering support has given me to that of a brother. To our outgoing MPP director, District General Andre Perez Pinsunser, for your invaluable briefing and advice. I understand the magnitude of the role I am assuming, but I am prepared to embrace the challenge and continue the commendable work that this trip has achieved thus far. My friends and colleagues at the office of the TPNT, as well as in my corporate units in CIDGSR, Regional Highway Patrol 3, PRO 3, PRO 5, PRO 6, PRO9, thank you for your camaraderie and support. To my family, my beloved Brian, my son Jared, who have been my closest confidants, my greatest critics, and sponsor supporters. To my parents, brothers, sisters, your unwavering presence means the world to me. To the dedicated officers and personnel of MPD, I hope that we can foster a culture characterized by discipline, integrity, fairness, and community trust throughout our stations and PCPs in the city. This culture is what guarantees organization of excellence in everything we do, including our commitment to fostering public trust and confidence. I am fairly convinced that one of my primary tasks, as I assume this new role, is to uphold the high confidence you have placed in me. My primary focus will be to diligently execute our responsibilities in delivering the programs outlined by the PNP leadership, accord on the GPNP's 5-box agenda, the PILA program, and the 7-point agenda of our regional director. In this capacity, I vow to work tirelessly alongside our dedicated team to ensure that these priorities are not just met but exceeded. Together, we shall strive our utmost to maintain the safety and the security of the city of Manila while upholding fundamentals, principles, and integrity that define the meaning of this service. Rest assured that I will work with you to make each day an opportunity for us to deliver the best police service to all Manilenos and to the Filipino people. Maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat. Mabuhay ang PNP. Mabuhay ang Manila Police.
Next month na, after the November 1, November 2 also for sensitive activities. That's available. And so thank you very much for sparing this 1 hour activity. We can see the usual change of human rights. To the outgoing district director, General Reason, our coming for the meetings of Premier and Sympathy, General Divine, District General Divine. The men and women of the MPD, friends from Manila, the officers, of course, we are here. The relatives, the brother and wife of Italy, please stand up. The class 1996-28 is done up. Thank you. And of course, I would like to acknowledge a former MP, former buddy, when we were in PR of Bulgaria, as well as in Special Action Force. Please stand up. Police, Major General Rolando Fernandez Miranda. How much that?
Leading this 4,050 personnel, 4,000
police dito. Maybe if 1.8-1.9 ang population, we have a an idea. 1:500 police population ratio. To be exact, it's something like 1,000. 1:455. So it's a good thing that you have this human resources for this. And because ating being mayora has been so generous in providing the necessary equipments and capabilities of the Philippine National Police, particularly MP, in terms of our mobility. I heard that the mobility assets here, we expect that 1:8, meaning isang police, walong police ay meron isang sasakyan. Palakpakan natin.
Improve the processes. If you will improve
the processes. Okay? And we call it be a transformational leader. Katulad ng ating butihing mayor, talakpakan natin. Napakadami programa, policy, at improvement para mag-improve and for lalo ibang ang kakalakang Maynila at for that matter, mabuhong Pilipinas. So, I have laid out for the information of our chief executive. I have laid out already our action plan in the implementation of focus crime, high focus crime between the beta program of our SIUD and other program necessary to be implemented through the action plan. Number one, sinabi na, management of human and material resources, one part of the action plan. Number two, we develop risk management plan at all level. May plano pa kayo pagka nawala ng kuryente dito? May have your contingencies? Pag sumakot ng isang bridge deck, you have your contingencies. Those are the things that I am referring to. Whether man-made or natural. Pagkagawa mo ngayon, the thing that you will be doing is you revisit, you craft action plans or security plans or vital installations and other areas of concern. Baka dito, hindi nyo alam kung ilan yung bako. Hindi nyo alam kung ilan yung kulay. So, those are the things. And then, you develop track security plans to all managements, to all activities, year-round. Number one dito, pagdating ng January, ano? Merong Chinese, ibig sabihin nung ito, Chinese New Year, meron tayong black na salin, napakadami trabaho. By this time, year din yung ginagawa yun, you should have a very good plan already, such that, may timeline na, alam nyo na, kailangan, implemented na. Pag sinabi yung plan, black na sa rin, alam nyo na kagad. Nandito ang ating NGO, alam nyo na kung paano nyo. So, ano ba yun? It's election. For 31 years, I've been in service. Last 4, 35 years. Si General Miranda, 39 years ng sa dating election namin na ginawa, ay siguro naman we have improved already in our security plans. At alam po si Jerome Granda, when he was the NPD director here, nag-iwan siya ng isang magandang action plan or security plans, specifically, not only for the election, but several activities that needed to be managed. So, pag nakayos mo yan, meron pa ulit. You need to look after the moral and welfare of your personnel. Yung ibang pulis yan, sinasabi mo nila, lalo na pa tumanda, mamamatay tao yan. Pero huwag ka nga, ibig sabihin ng mamamatay tao, pinapatay kasi sa tutul. Hindi ito sa sinasaksak o pinapatay sa tutul. So, look at the moral and welfare of your personnel. Okay? Of course, we would like to have an operational aspect, kailangan magtrabaho tayo. Our campaign against loose firearms, illegal drugs, as well as terrorism. Here in Manila, kailangan secure ito. You can do it from cycling 1 to 6 yung sinasabi ko kanina. Okay? You should have a mastery of what you are servicing kung nandito kayo sa Manila. Alam mo, excited. Ito yung parang regular. Okay? And lastly, of course, our management of police operation. Enhanced managing police operation. Alam mo na yan. In details, this action plan, our beloved mayor of Manila, gumawa na po kami na this action plan was written in a leader's queue guy. Hawak na nila, fill in the blanks na ang tawag to, the people's sky now. Pag hindi siya na ipitin yan, okay? So, once again, thank you God for witnessing this James or that cover of the man we are going to lead to everyone. Bless up.
Thank you very much for your message, sir. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm talking about the introduction of the guest of honor and speaker. May we now request the newly installed district director of Manila Police District, no other than Police Colonel Arnold Thomas Kabugao Ibay, sir.
Thank you. As the newly installed district director of the Manila Police District, I have the singular honor to introduce our guest of honor and speaker today, Honorable Maria Sheila Lacuna, the City Mayor of Manila.
Hindi po siya pwedeng lumuhin ng mga taong ito. lahat ng kalye dito sa resort ng Maynila. Alam mo, ito ba yun? Ang haba na ito po. Good morning po sa inyo lahat. Especially to our NCRPO, Acting Regional Director, Police Brigadier General Jose Melencio Tantares Jr. Our incoming acting district director of our Manila Police District, Colonel Arnold Thomas. Our outgoing district director, Brigadier General Andre Dizon. FPD deputy directors, Colonel Ronald Kakapa and Colonel Robert Salor. Our staff and the men and women of the Manila Police District. Allow me to express our profound gratitude to the 14 months of service of General Andre Dizon in the city of Manila. He came almost at the same time of my assumption into office as the city's local chief executive last year. He has shown his dedication and compassion to his task. True to his popular tagline of approachable, presentable, and dependable, which became an inspiration to the entire police force in the city. General Dizon was well regarded by our I Love Manila team, comprised of all the heads of various departments, offices, and bureau chiefs, for his humble aura, so easy to deal with, and very reliable. His support and cooperation to the city government was truly felt. Gusto din man namin na malatili kayo po sa Maynila, ginagalang namin ang desisyon ng liderato ng Philippine National Police. Dalangin lang sana namin na ikaw ay gabayan ng Panginoon sa bago yugto ng iyong buhay police. We say thank you very much. We wish you all the best on your new assignment. Pamilis na namin sa Christmas presentation natin sa Christmas. Sa punto ito naman, ay burong galak din namin pinakanggap ang bagong tuma. Bago sa kanya ng designation bilang acting district director ng Manila Police District at luma sapagkat ilang pabalik-balik na din si Colonel Arnold Thomas Ibay sa Maynila. Siguro, lagi naririnig ni Colonel Ibay ang kanta na Maynila, pinahanap, hanap, at lahat. Ang ino mo ay sarap sa Maynila. We are welcoming you back to the city of Manila. The city have loved to serve for many years as a police captain, police major, police colonel, and soon as police general. You were designated as one of the PCP commanders, as a station commander, as MPP chief directional staff, and you were given many other assignments such as deputy regional director, provincial director, CIPG NCR chief, and senior executive assistant to the chief PNP, among others. The hierarchy of our Philippine National Police must have seen and recognized your kind of service and your style of leadership. At ngayon lang, nagbabalik ang muli, dito sa kapitolyo ng aking bansa, naniniwala akong kabisado ko na ang kalagayan ng aking puso. Bigbig mo pa ang iyong mga karanasan sa lahat ng mga posisyon na pinagkatiwala sa iyo. Umaasa ako padadama muli sa aming mga Manilenyo ang iyong buong pagmamalasakit, buong sipag at sigasig. At umundaling na pamunuan ang may halos 4,000 pulis na ito. Sa mga susunod natin pag-uusap, madalas uinom. Pagtutulong, pagsasama sa iba't ibang mga proyekto at programa ng pamahalaang lungsod ay umaasa akong makakatulungan kayo, magkakatulungan kayo at ibibigay mo ang iyong 101% upang mapanatili natin ang kaisan, kapayapaan at kaligtasan ng bawat isang mamamayan ng Maynila. And rest assured that the city government of Manila will be behind you and the whole of the Manila Police. May isang lang lamang po ako. Kaya mo magsayaw at kumanta sa Christmas presentation namin. Kaya ginawa ko niyo ng channel ng Jibiso kung nakaraan ka ako. Kami po ay isang masayang grupo. Kaya ano pong hirap ng aming kukunin na mapanatili ang kaayusan ng Maynila, hindi po namin kinakalimutan ang pagiging tao. Kaya yun po ay ini-expect din namin sa inyo. At lalo na ang pakikipagkapwa. To both of you, General Dizon and Colonel Ibai, tuta, more power and God bless. Sabi nga, ang inyong uniforme bilang pulis ay hindi basta uniforme. Ang pagkos, iyan ay simbolo ng tiwala at kapangyarihan. Be your best in serving our beloved country. Snapping salute to you, gentlemen. Maraming salamat at isang mapagpalang araw po sa inyo.
Thank you very much for your very inspiring message, ma'am. And also, Maria Sheila, Manila Punipana. And now let us proceed to the presentation of the memento to the guest of honor and speaker. We request our acting regional director, police leader, general of seven elections in our Cadres Junior to be assisted by the incoming and outgoing district directors of Manila Police District.
Salutation greetings. In grateful appreciation and gratitude for her invaluable support and contribution to the Manila Police District as guest of honor and speaker during the turnover of command ceremony. This plaque of appreciation is presented to Honorable Maria Sheila Manila Punapakan, the city mayor of Manila. And of course, another plaque of appreciation is represented by the district director to the regional director of the National Capital Region, and grateful acknowledgement and recognition of his leadership and remarkable commitment and support to Manila Police District during the takeover of command ceremony. This plaque of appreciation is presented to Police Brigadier General of Seven and Children Actors Junior. Ladies and gentlemen, request everyone to please all lights for the singing of the Awi Tamayla. Will be subsequently followed by the singing of PNPA. PNPA, Nicole Napayo.
Thank you.
institution and that concludes our turnover of command ceremony for today. Once again, let's give a round of applause for guest of honor, speaker, Once again, ladies and gentlemen, this is your Manila Police District. Your Manila's